Boy, do we have an update for you. Welcome to Expedition Engineering. We have a big update. We also have a lot of wind.
There's no way they're gonna hear you.
We're going to the shop.
I know it's because I grew up in the desert, but fall leaves are just so aesthetic.
I wish you could buy those in craft stores.
I think you can.
Real Maine leaves.
We have grown out of our space. The project has outgrown us, honestly, but we will persevere, and we have just rented a larger shop space to work, so now we need to move it. Let's go.
But we can't, it's actually not very far away, but to get to our new space, we have to go out and around to the other door. Yep. So it is gonna be a little bit of a hike.
Yep.
This is a slightly temporary situation. The guys next to us are leaving tomorrow, and so we'll be able to make our space a little bit bigger when they leave. But for now, this is what we got. We want to work today. We could have waited till tomorrow to have our bigger space, but we want to get going. So today we're gonna start sanding, grinding. Got a lot to do. And today's pizza day. I just finished up grinding. It's definitely lighter now. This new space is already amazing. We got this all ground down and now it's getting a bath. You can see where Jade has wiped exactly. That's dust, that's not dust. So what we did is we ground down all of the high spots and now we are going to get the parts ready that need to get more carbon and just basically put on carbon where there needs to be carbon. So we're gonna put it on all these curves down here.
That's a really good explanation.
I thought so.
Yeah.
Wherever there needs to be carbon that
we're
there isn't,
gonna,
there's going to be.
The work that needs to be done.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's it.
Right. Simple.
And before we do that work, we do the work, the prep work to do that work, which is this. I just discovered the key to vlogging. Believe it or not, this used to be clear.
Like 2 seconds ago. That's one
dip. That's one dip of the rag. Wow.
I wish I could show you how I have the camera propped up. We don't have any of our tripods or mounts or anything.
Oh,
I grabbed the other GoPro. You can see you're up there on the power place, but this is here with this stick with a brush on the bottom. Ta-da! Vlogging.
We're professionals.
Actually, no.
It's the amount of camera gear that we have and that this is how we're filming right now. I love it.
The current dilemma is how to get off the mold release wax. We can't sand it because it just comes with the sandpaper. Acetone doesn't touch it, and so we are trying dish soap. Actually, I think it's hand soap. Is it working?
I don't know yet. It's lathery, and it smells like... There's this like certain kind of cheap dish or cheap hand soap. It's sometimes in public restrooms. Does anybody know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, you're right. It's often in like truck stops and,
yeah. And I've always,
gas station
life,
bathrooms.
I've liked the smell of it.
Zep?
I've never heard of Zep. Is that a soap?
Yeah. What Jade is so expertly doing right now is drawing the 1-inch line down so that we know where to cut. And we're gonna trim this all shorter.
Moments during this project where I'm like, this is kind of crazy. Like this is cool. Like crazy cool. I'm really proud of this. So we're building things from scratch and engineering and designing.
I am working on how the windows are gonna mount. So we've got another lip in here. Need to have a lip come up and need to continue this lip around up here as well. And then it'll rest up against this and up against this. So it's just making this lip all the way around, and then threw some fairing filler on it. But you can see now it has a lip all the way around this window. And on the inside, one window mostly done, one window area, I guess. And then just gotta do the other, what is it? 1, 2, 3, 4. And there's actually gonna be ones here and here. And Jade has been out here building the back half of this curve, because this is the Dodger arch, remember? And this has tons and tons of load on it. So we're making this super strong. It's super bulked, super strong all the way through it. And now this comes up here, which is what I was working on the other side, strong. But then this is actually gonna flare back as well to go there to help support this rear section, because from here to the rear arch, no, that's not true. I was gonna say it's unsupported, but that's not true. There actually is gonna be a leg, a small leg right here that we haven't really shown, but that's holding a lot of weight and structure. So this is gonna be super strong combined with this, making this Dodger arch very, very strong.
What I'm doing next is I need to get the gutters and the curved edges built for this big piece right here, which is the center section that will connect the aft dinghy davit section with the Dodger section.
So this to that.
This connects them. And so we need the gutters and the curves, but we need it to match here once it's all bolted together. So I've just made a little form.
It looks so good though.
And so I can flip this over and we can lay the carbon in it. Over here, I sandwiched it. I did two layers of carbon and I sandwiched some foam on either side to see.
Ooh, I bet that's way stiffer.
I wanted to see if it would give the rigidity. So I wanted to try both, but I didn't want to use all of our resources on making a form that'll just get thrown away, you know? Oh yeah, that's.
It's already way stiffer.
Enough.
It's even stiffer here.
Yeah, this is, well, because it's two layers.
Oh, that one's only one layer?
Yeah, so maybe I'll add a, this is actually great.
Yeah.
That works great. So ultimately, this is what the curve needs to end up at. Like that. It's up with the Dodger. So if we pair that here.
Because then right here, it'll transition to this little one.
So we've got a transition. It's going to be a compound curve, right? So here's our gutter like this. So you see the difference in the angles?
Yep.
Like that. So it's
not kind of, drastic.
It's not drastic, but it's gonna have to come in.
Yeah. And I am working on this. I've been framing out the windows. You can see this is the window frame. So the windows will sit up against this lip here, this leg lip, and then here. And so I got all the foam there, throwing a layer of fairing filler, and then it's really rough right now. So luckily we have Fernando and his Hello. Expertise. Fernando's gonna be helping us out with sanding all this, hanging out with us for the day. And tomorrow he's headed to Brazil.
Yes.
So we only get him for a day. So we're gonna make good use and try and get him not too itchy. Hopefully we'll just sand mostly fairing filler, not too much fiberglass and carbon.
I'm taking my shower before going.
That's right, yeah, definitely. And maybe throw a little laundry in. So lip all the way around, and we'll get it sanded up. And then hopefully, by the end of the day, this will be it. Probably have another layer of fairing on it, honestly.
Black powder.
Right, delicious. Brandon just finished up with the hand sander, the power sander. Knocked down all the high spots. So now he's going through with the Dremel, getting in the groove here. Basically, we're just getting down all the high spots so we can get ready to put on more filler. So he's earned his lunch.
There's a little bit of nothing in the time lapse.
Yeah, for lunch, I saw that.
Well, that's that. We're headed back. Fernando has been time lapsed. Brett was upstairs editing,
yep.
Shirking his work, passing it off to some unsuspecting victim. That's Fernando.
Hi again.
Paid him in food.
Yeah, we're like, you just come stay at the boat. And then we're like,
Also, bring clothes that you can get itchy and dirty in.
I'm still not quite sure if the inches belong to the t-shirt or because here is also itchy.
Oh, that's probably
a little bit.
Yeah, that's probably from the shop.
Well, yeah. We recently learned a trick. I learned it from a forum. So sometimes forums actually do have helpful information. Don't be fooled. Sometimes, if you take pantyhose and rub it, the material of the pantyhose pulls the fibers out of your skin pretty well, and it actually helps a lot. And I decided to give it a try because I figured a bunch of grown men recommending to other grown men on this forum to rub pantyhose all over their bodies, to go buy it and then rub it. I was like, all right, there's got to be some value here, otherwise there's no way. And it's true, it works. So we have a huge pack of like XXXL pantyhose because it was the same price. So we just got the most material we could possibly get, and we've been using that, and it has been helping.
It does help. So Fernando can rub the pantyhose on his arms.
I guess I will have to give you a try now.
Whoa! What is going on?
That's interesting.
Are they having a police festival?
Festival? Wow, yeah, that's a lot of police.
Seriously? Mm. Fun fact.
Yeah, but why is there so many police?
The police in Barcelona are all very fit, and that's in the American and English definition. Like British definition.
Fit.
They're all gorgeous and strong. All the men, all the women, like the police here, I've never seen such great looking officers ever.
Now, didn't you try and get arrested the other day?
We saw this guy at the passport stamping office walk by, and I was like, I've never wanted to be arrested before. And Britt's like dying laughing.
We're sending off Fernando. We went rock climbing. And now he has to go to the airport because he has an early flight and there's no way to get to the airport early.
It was harder for the skin of the hands than the carbon fiber was.
Oh, yeah? warmed up your hands with a sander and carbon fiber, and now you're warm out.
The time has gone. The time has... We're gonna weigh this. We've got our Dodger right here, right now, in our nice big space with these vaulted ceilings. And we're about to figure out how heavy it is because it's been feeling like it's getting heavier and heavier and heavier, which has been concerning Brett's fishing. You can do it.
Nice.
That was impressive. Okay. So, it's been getting heavy the last little bit. We finished these curves and now we're just kind of fairing it out and filling it, making it look really nice. We're working on the aesthetics and the finishing portions now. But after we filled those structural components, these gussets on the side, started getting heavier and heavier and heavier every time we were lifting it. So we're getting a little worried that it's going to be too heavy. And we also want to know how much Brett can curl. That's off the ground. 99 pounds, baby. 99 pounds.
That's how much my fingers can hold. Can't get any heavier.
Oh my gosh. I need to lift weights more because I thought that it was a lot heavier than 100 pounds. That is really good news, Brett.
Really good news.
Brett. I thought it was way heavier than that.
Yeah, well, we kind of picked it up yesterday and we guessed 130 was our guess. 130, 140, somewhere in there.
Yeah, which is a lot more.
Apparently, we need to work out a little more. Our calibration is off.
That is so great.
That's great news.
That is so great. Good job curling that.
Thanks.
So, next, we just need to weigh this one. No, that's really like spread out, but this is dense, man.
Yeah. If that's true, these legs are almost completely solid.
Uh-huh.
Those aren't. Those are completely hollow.
Those are completely hollow, and the legs have internal structuring as well.
Yep. Yeah, because there's a thin, solid piece.
Wrapped in fiberglass.
Wrapped in fiberglass, wrapped in carbon.
Wrapped in carbon, yeah.
Yeah, this is pretty solid.
It's really solid.
All right, let's get this over and go eat lunch.
Okay.
should have kept all those tubes. It's been like an art piece.
I feel like this is our art piece right here.
It is. Yeah. That's
a gorgeous. This is good. This is what it'll look like. It'll be centered on your guys' screen.
It's up there. You have to tilt it right.
Yeah. You're like that. So slick. What do you want? Oh, that looks so good. The distortion on the GoPro makes it look a little different. We'll show you on the big camera, but it looks so slick.
Yay.
Lunchtime.